It's Olivier, and then Niyonshuti. That's Niyonshuti, and then Shyaka, that's Shyaka. Olivier Niyonshuti Shyaka.
So, hello, my name is Becca Brin, and I am here today with my friend Olivier. Would you like to introduce yourself fully? What year are you?
So my name's Olivier Niyonshuti, and I'm a student, an international student actually. I'm a sophomore majoring in international relations and minoring in business. And I'm originally from Rwanda, Kigali, Rwanda.
So how long or when was the last time that you went home?
Yeah, I was here since December 13th of last year. So it's been here so far. So 1 year is going to wrap up. Since I was home, so.
Are you going home for the holidays?
No, I'll be here.
You'll be here? So have you made your own home here, would you say?
Yeah, I've made my own home here. I've found a family here, I've found friends, you know. I'm not getting to know the place, I'm getting to like the place, you know, move around the country, you know. Move down to DC, move down to New York, you know. Even to the South, you know. Even planning to go to Canada, so I found a family here. Because my brother graduated from here in 2015, he said it's fine if you come to St. Michael's College because it's a good place where you can learn and focus, you know. There's not a lot of obstructions, like maybe somebody who goes to Miami, you know. Imagine going to school in Miami, you know, a lot of parties, you know. The weekends are not for school, you know. But Vermont, even if we do the weekends and we have fun, but there's not a lot of things that could obstruct you and stop you from studying. It's a nice environment, even if it's cold, you know. But you have to keep up with it. So it's kind of good, like, it's a good environment and a good state for school, I would say. Yeah, that's why I decided to come here. But under the influence of my brother, I wanted to be a soldier or something, you know. But I know my uncle used to tell me that every kid, when they're still young, especially boys, they want to be soldiers, you know, they want to be those heroes, you know, they want to save the world, mean serving people, you know. Saving mankind and working for the sake of humanity. So, and the reason I did not be a soldier as I wanted to be, I did not go to serve, maybe be in the army as I wanted to be. But all I know and all I can do right now is find another way to serve humanity. Studying international relations will help me to work with those non-government organizations. You might even work with the United Nations, you know, as a way of fulfilling your dreams, you know. So one of my dreams is like be in a position where you can be able to help mankind and also help to solve one of the world's challenges right now, which is like wars and whatever. So if maybe we're in those positions where we can be able to make decisions and say maybe this decision should be made and the people made this bad decision should be punished for it, I believe we could change the world. So it's a nice field that I'm passionate about and I really enjoy studying.
Do you think one day you may go back and serve for the Rwandan army?
No, I don't plan to serve. I usually say it's not too late, but I have already passed those dreams. I don't want to serve anymore.
That's fair.
Yeah. I want to work for the United Nations. Yeah, that's one of my dreams. That's one of the things I need to do with my degree.
What do you think introduced you to the United Nations? In that idea, that dream?
Yeah, I don't know. I wouldn't say maybe I have an uncle who works with the United Nations. Just like being passionate about something, you find the ways and you feel like you need to make research and maybe know if I want to be like, maybe if you want to be like a journalist, you know. You find a way that you can work close to maybe being maybe a CNN journalist, you know, maybe being a BBC journalist, Al Jazeera. So it's like, you find a way that if it means going to school, you find the things that you can study that will lead you to that dream of yours or ambition of yours that you want to accomplish. So I wouldn't say somebody introduced me to work with the United Nations. It's one of the things that came through me and say maybe you would help humankind, you would work with people, you would work with humanitarian organizations, like the United Nations High Commission for Refugees, you know. Under those organizations. So
what made you choose the United States and coming to the United States for education?
You can say, and America's education is way better than not only in my country, but any other countries around this globe.
You previously mentioned that you did decide on St. Michael's a lot due to your brother. So what does family mean to you?
Yeah, probably I usually like tell myself like family to me, before I came in the United States, family to me was and maybe my brothers, my mom or my dad, because I grew up most of the time away from home because I did not attend like middle school, elementary school. Back home, I did not attend it like in my own country. I was in another country, so, and I had no family like by blood, so close. So family were those friends who were always there when my mom, my brothers were not there. So to me, first of all, I consider family. Family is somebody who decides to come in your life. It doesn't matter whether they are not your brothers or if they are not your sisters. As long as somebody is good to you in your life, that's the first family I have. If I need somebody to help, the friend who is close to me is the one who is going to help. So to me, friends mean family.
If you had to recommend this studying abroad, living abroad, learning abroad, would you do it?
Yeah, I would do it because I know most of my, not only me, like even most of my friends would love to learn abroad, you know, to come and study abroad. So I think it's a good opportunity, first of all, to be in a new place where you can learn new things. Because I believe it's not only the purpose of education that I'm here, but also learn new things, learn from different people, you know. The culture is always different, so it's always good to know different culture. Because culture is one way of understanding another, you know. So if you learn the culture of one person, you'll be able to understand those people, you know. So if you learn their culture, it's one way you live the life those people are living. And if you're living the life those people are living, they're going to live the life you're living too. Because if you be able to teach them your culture, they'll learn it and you learn from them. So that's how people get together, you know. That's how people become brothers, you know. That's how people become family, you know, as we said, you know. That's how people develop an understanding of each other. And they can help and they can work together to make this world a better place to live.